Corporate stories now. Andrew Tan's Alliance Global Group set to expand its hotel operations. AGI is adding 6 new locations to its portfolio by 2028. The group is growing its hotel capacity to around 11,000 room keys under the Megaworld Hotels and Resorts brand. The new hotels will be located in several areas from here in Metro Manila to Boracay, Inaklan, and in Palawan Islands. As for Wilcon Depot, it reports a 50% increase in net income at 3.8 billion pesos. The company saying this was generated from net sales of over 33.5 billion pesos, up 22% year on year. It adds higher growth sales driven largely by its Metro Manila stores, contributed mainly to the total sales growth of the company. Now, Wilcon Depot is also bullish on its goal to open up to 10 more stores this year. The Philippine Ombudsman is urged to resolve the graft case filed against former Central Bank Governor Amado Tetangco Jr. Joselito Yu Huico, the heir of one of the former officials of General Bank and Trust Company, said it's been 10 years since the complaint was filed. He explained the complainant cannot help but feel that he is a victim of delayed administration of justice. Yu Huico, along with his brother Adirito, and Rosa Karam, the widow of GenBank stockholder Fermin Karam Jr., filed the complaint. Businessman Lucio Tan acquired GenBank, which eventually became Allied Banking Corporation. The complainants alleged Tetangco and the others gave undue advantage to Allied Bank when they approved its merger with the Philippine National Bank. For the first time since the pandemic, a Philippine delegation led by the Trade Department holds an investment roadshow in several European countries. The DTI says this aims to highlight the Philippines as a viable investment destination for European investors. Sectors such as manufacturing, research and development, and renewable energy will be given priority. The European Investment Roadshow kicked off on June 18, which will be in France, Belgium, the United Kingdom, the Netherlands, and Germany until July 6. The Philippines' outstanding external debt hits a record high of $118 billion in the first quarter. Preliminary data from the central bank showed external debt climbed by 8.3% from the previous $109.8 billion recorded year on year. According to the BSP, the rise was driven primarily by the statistical adjustment involving the inclusion of the non-resident holdings of peso-denominated debt securities, which were issued onshore in the debt stock. Now, the growth was also impelled by net availments of the national government, prior periods adjustments, and the appreciation of other currencies against the U.S. dollar. Despite the rise, though, the central bank notes the country's external debt ratio remains at a prudent level. The Philippine Central Bank posts a net loss of 1.4 billion pesos in the first quarter of the year. The BSP recognized 11 billion in net losses from foreign exchange rate fluctuations in 2022. That's a reversal of the 17.46 billion in net gains last year. The BSP posted revenues of 38.55 billion pesos, a 7.4% drop from the previous year. Revenues mostly came from interest income on foreign investments and government securities. Meanwhile, expenses more than doubled to 49.63 billion pesos. Overall, the central bank's net worth stood at 143.75 billion pesos at the end of the first quarter, and that's higher than the 98.51 billion pesos clocked in the previous year.